rolling hills, broad lakes and historic towns. Today we are in the most amazing, beautiful, wonderful county in the country. I'm a bit biased. We're in County Monaghan, my hometown. So I'm going to show you a few of the must-see things you have to do when you come to visit. First on my list is a venue dedicated to one of Monaghan's greatest talents. It's not me. It's definitely not me. It is, of course, the incredible Irish poet Patrick Kavanagh. Come on, let's take a look. Darren, tell us a little bit more about why the Patrick Kavanagh Centre got set up.
So the Patrick Kavanagh Centre was set up essentially to celebrate the life and work of Patrick Kavanagh, who is a native of Inniskeen. And back in 1994, when the centre was originally set up, you had a lot of people coming to Inniskeen, basically almost like a pilgrimage. They were like, we want to know more. We want to know more about the landscape and the rolling hills and rivers of Inniskeen and Monaghan that Kavanagh writes so beautifully about. So local community groups came together and basically decided, you know, we have an unused church here. Let's turn that into the Patrick Kavanagh Centre. So in 1994, the Patrick Kavanagh Centre was born.
And obviously, Patrick Kavanagh is a huge part of the curriculum. So do you get school kids? You know, who generally comes to visit?
We have a broad mix of people that come to visit. So like in terms of the schools, yes, Kavanagh is on the curriculum, but it's not just kids that are studying him for the leaving cert. Like Kavanagh famously didn't finish school. He left school at 13, but he had a voracious appetite for knowledge and wanted to be a poet. He knew that he had this capacity and facility with words.
One thing that really strikes me as well is Raglan Road, probably one of the greatest Irish songs of all time. He was the man who wrote the lyrics for that song.
Yeah, one of the great things about Kavanagh's poetry, if you read it, there's a native musicality to it, and that's one of the things that differentiates him from other great poets.
I'm not the biggest with poetry, unfortunately, even being from the same county as Patrick, but I believe you have something here that can even help the most novice when it comes to poetry.
Yeah, well, it's the Poetry Jukebox down by the river. Sure, let's go see it.
Okay, come on, let's go. Okay.
On Raglan Road of an autumn day.
Oh, stony grey soil of Monaghan, the laugh from my love you thieved. You took the gay child of my passion and gave me your cloud conceived.
Right, that's the culture box tick. Now let's get the adrenaline going at the Castle Blaney Outdoor Adventure Centre. Mark, this is a place I used to love coming for the summer holidays back in the day. I mean, what activities? Because it looks like there's an awful lot more here available than back in my day.
Yeah, no, brilliant. We really do a lot of water and land activities. So as you can see in the background here, we've canoeing. There's kids over here doing kayaking. We also do sailing, stand-up paddleboarding, archery to orienteering to tree climbing. So it really is lots to do.
Okay, you have loads of activities to do. I'm a bit nervous. What have you got lined up for me?
Right, so today, Tommy, you will be climbing over here in front of the centre, a majestic Douglas fir tree. So
oh, back climbing tree, I'll take me back to my youth. Okay,
yeah,
good.
So you're trying that. And then after that, you'll be trying our stand-up paddleboarding.
Oh, it can be so keen on that. Things you do for Ireland Day, you know, right. And just like hands on this.
Hands on, yep, work the legs up first. The legs are stronger, so just kind of push through the legs. And I'm on a new vibration.
I'm building my own foundation, yeah. Hola, oh baby. All right. I'm up. It's really high. You won't break my soul.
I tell everybody. That's it, well done.
Nailed it.
Fair play.
That was scary up there.
No, I'll let you out now.
There's no way Alan Hughes would have done that. No chance. Release the stress, release it all, forget the rest. Right, Kelly, challenge number two. What have you got for me?
I'm going to go some paddleboarding. Have you done it before?
Yes, but it wasn't very good.
It'll be grand today. So we'll start down on your knees so you kind of get used to the balance a little bit. Okay. Once you get into the middle of the lake, away from the decking, then we will get your balance and get you standing up. I'm sleeping real good at night. The queens in the front and the doms in the back. Ain't taking no flicks, but the whole click snap. Just a whole lot of people in the house. Trying to smoke with the yak in your mouth. And we
you're back outside. You said you outside, but you ain't that outside. Worldwide hoodie with the mask outside. In case you forgot how we act outside.
Oh. Hi, Kelly. Any more activities?
That is you done for the day. I think it's time you go get yourself a pint.
I know just the place.
Watermelon sugar, strawberries on a summer evening.
Now I'm here at the Brehan Brewhouse with Seamus and Siobhan McMahon, who are here to give me a bit of a show around. Seamus, tell us, you're full-time dairy farmers. How did you get into brewing beer?
Well, I suppose we as I said, we're 120 cows here on the farm, fluctuating price, like everything else. Monaghan people, inventive, decided to diversify.
From dairy to beer, is it just, I suppose liquid, it's all the same. It good,
yeah, it's much the same, the process. You know, it's a primary product, only it tastes different. It's a primary product. The difference is the milkman comes, collects the milk. The difference of the beer is you have to sell it.
75% of our beer sales are exports.
Okay.
We sell to France and Germany,
Italy.
And Italy.
All the EU countries, yeah. UK, USA. Yeah.
So you're a full-time dairy farmer with beer on the side. How's business?
Busy, actually busy. You know, I suppose we came out of COVID, came out pretty much unscathed. Our exports held up pretty well.
Okay, well, you're not busy enough to show me around.
Never too busy.
Are we going to taste, or do we have to show how it's made first?
I have to see it first, Tommy, and then we can taste.
Right, okay. Lead me away.
Basically, there's really only four ingredients in beer. There's barley, water, yeast and hops. We feed the grain to the cattle. The wastewater goes into the tanks and it's spread in the land. You'd be able to bottle about 6,000 bottles within the day.
Now, you're teasing me here. When are we going to get to taste
oh,
it?
Oh, no, come on, we'll okay. Get you around to
right,
the
come on, this is my favourite bit.
The important bit.
Seamus.
Tommy, how are
your
you?
Your wife has promised me a good beer.
Oh, jeez.
What have we got for me?
We've some good beers, yeah. So look, we're in Killarney here, Tommy, so I suppose Killarney Red, maybe?
Killarney Red, I remember beating them on the football field many years ago. Cheers to that.
Cheers to that indeed, Tommy.
So there you have it, culture, activities, beautiful scenery, and of course, great beer. I told you it was the best county in the country. Keep discovering. Sugar.